Now let's go and try how to use a blank report option. Under the Create button, if you click and hover over New Report, you have the option Blank Report. Once clicked, you will be given four prompts. And these prompts are limited to dates. As you may recall from Report Builder, when you make a selection for date sign number one question, you will be required to make an entry for end date for date sign, which is the question number two. Or if you make a selection to make an entry for number three question, you have to answer end date for last modified date. They work in pairs, and the span between those pairs are 12 years. In the last example, I used date signed because most of the contracts are queried against their date signed, executed date. So I'm going to keep using this sample again. And in this case, I'm going to go for one fiscal year. As you may see at the bottom left corner of the report template entry level, you will have edit in design mode. Once clicked, you will be given a blank canvas. Only report filter that you will see is date signed between the dates that you selected. Up all objects, as I mentioned earlier, this is the entire FPDS data living in award IDB information. Once clicked, you will see the root folder. Inside of the root folder, you have two options, public objects and schema objects. First, I will make a selection on schema objects. Schema objects are the attributes. Once you click on the attributes, you will see the business area of interest grouped according to the data that's driven from current FPDS legacy system. In order to find attributes that you like, you can type the keyword in the blank area, such as department, and click magnifying glass. And by double clicking on attributes, you will add them to your report. In order to see the entire name of the attribute, since they are long, you hover over the center line, hold it with left button, and expand it. You can read them easily. In this case, I'm going to continue with my same sample from the report builder. In order to clear this, you have to highlight the box and hit backspace, then hit enter. That will take you back to business area of interest. Or you can use the top one level and go all the way to the root. Or from this navigation dropdown, you can select the root menu as you wish. Next set will be the public objects. When I click on public objects, I will be shown metrics. Once I select metrics, I will have two options, granular metrics and metrics. You would like to choose metrics. Granular metrics is level specific metric, which we are not interested for our example. I'll be choosing total contract value by double clicking on it, and number of actions. Now, if I click here and select award information, I'll be quickly brought back to the root folder. Now, we are in the all objects. In here, I have report objects. I can select report objects and see what I'm seeing on the grid itself, on the navigation menu. I can quickly select them and drag them to report filter. As you may recall, report filter was the area where I modified the conditions that needs to be satisfied in order to be in this report. Contracting department ID qualify ID equals to, I know the number, 4700. And I can hit apply. Or by clicking on this hyperlink, I can edit it. I can say select and add 4700 by entering it for search for box and clicking on magnifying glass, entering it in the selected area, and I can have multiple of them, 9700, which is Department of Defense, and edit it here. At the end, I need to hit apply. Now I have two contracting department IDs selected, 4700 and 9700, to be in this report. And I can quickly add more items to report filter by dragging them in here. Place of manufacture, I can do a select, and it will give me options in here, which I'm not familiar with, but it needs to be place of manufacture. Or I can qualify them on ID begins with, let's say A, and hit apply. So I have three conditions here: date signed, filter, and contracting department ID in list, place of manufacture begins with. All these operators are covered in our reference guide. Once complete with my selection, I can save this report. Once I click on save, since it's the first time that I'm saving this, I'll be prompted to save as box. Again, I'll keep everything as default. Okay. And I'll be given two options. I can go back to the design mode or run newly saved report. Once clicked, I'll be shown the default answers that I made for my prompts. There were date signed and end date signed. I can run the report. I'm not going to be given the option to alternate department IDs since they weren't prompts. I created those report filters on the conditions that I entered while I was building my report. Now, we have one condition that satisfied this report. Since I placed place of manufacture begins with A, it only pulled up a Department of Defense contracts and aggregate them at this level. In order to perfect your report, you can go back to design mode by selecting report and design. Once you are here, you can get rid of this condition by clicking on this X. And you can click on save to overwrite the report definition that you initially made, or you can save as and create a new version that I would do like here. Once it's clicked, I will be given the same option again and run newly saved report. I'll be shown the prompts again. And I will run my report and it will execute against the database and will bring the data results in seconds. Now, I have 39 rows of data since I removed the condition of place of manufacture from the very close of my report. This will conclude how to create a report by using blank report option.